Hey guys, welcome back to Puggsy. Thank you so much for joining us. All right, we're going to head into the pyramids today and see if we can't sweep out all these levels, kind of complete them all. All right, so we have a remote control here. We have a mummy up above us, a raccoon mummy. That's kind of weird. He has an eyeball on him. So when we use this remote controller, we'll actually switch the camera angle over to this guy. The gimmick of this level is that we're going to need to get him to the top of the pyramid to ultimately hit a switch, which will allow us to get here to the exit door. Okay. He kind of follows us around, so he's going to follow our left and rights, but it's very floaty. And it's kind of difficult for me to describe the whoa, he jumped up there to describe the controls in this situation. I don't know, he follows your left and right, he jumps randomly, and he kind of sticks to edges so he doesn't fall down, so it's a little bit forgiving in that regard. But I don't know, it's just, it's very weird. I'm not sure if I like it. I definitely don't hate it because I don't get really frustrated. I'm able to complete this with, you know, relative ease. I don't know, it just feels very weird. Whoa, check out those really cool statues. Okay, so here we are at the end. Basically, we almost made it. If you can hit that far right switch that you saw there, it'll actually drop a coin down for us to take into the exit. We didn't get it, but ultimately it really doesn't matter, does it? Alright, so we got a few points there. And now we have the pyramids too, alright? Let's just keep going. Keep rocking and a-rolling here in the pyramids. You know what? That Mario 64 level with the pyramid, that one always beat the shit out of me as a kid. Not gonna lie, I always fell in the quicksand, and I, like, got deathly afraid of that quicksand. Mario is just, like, gasping for air, reaching out for help. Ugh, it's terrifying. Anyway, so we have a door here that we can't really press in. There's a switch underneath us that we need to hit, and this is gonna introduce a new gimmick here. That weird little thing with the coils on it, the glass canister, well that is actually a teleporter. When you throw an item into it, the item will teleport around. We need to get a ball. Oh, actually a ball already went in there somehow. Hey, we got two balls in there. Make that three. Okay, we got three on the switch. I think that's enough. So yeah, there'll be teleporters now in the game where we can move stuff around. It's pretty cool. Not gonna lie about it. Okay, so we're gonna hit this switch. We're just gonna free those two raccoons down there. One of them has a beer. The other a gun, apparently, and they're actually going to hit a few switches for me. I don't know, you can barely see it on the bottom right, but now they've hit those. And unfortunately, in hitting those switches, we've also freed this guy. This is an invincible mummy that will chase us around until we get to the exit. But we're running! Okay, whew. We made it out alright. We had sneakers, so it really wasn't a problem. But you got to make sure those two mummy raccoons in the middle hit the switches in there. Or else you're going to be stuck up against a door while that thing just grinds into you, wasting all your lives. Very frustrating. And okay, we got another locked door here. We got another really quick exit. We just got to figure out a way. Hey, you can die though. Haha. Got to find a way to open this door. Now, we got a little shape here. I don't know if you've pieced it together yet. It's like that old game you used to play as a kid where you fit the shapes into the, you know, the big block. Fit the shape into the corresponding shape hole. Alright, so now we have a triangle here. But actually, what you want to do with the triangle, you don't want to throw it in just yet. You want to take it down a little bit lower, so you can... Well, actually, I still have sneakers. Oh, I may not need to bring this. Oh yeah, I don't need to bring it at all. If you don't have the sneakers, you're going to need to do this, because you're not going to be able to progress at all over here. You're not going to be able to make that jump. I can make this jump. So, we made that jump. We're going to head up. We're going to get this plus sign in there. Why not? Another one. We only have two more shapes, a triangle and a square. Now, I do think I'm going to need it for this bottom one. Yes, so no matter what, you are going to need one for the bottom. So make sure you bring one with you. Let's do a little bit of a bounce jump here. Woo! Right up the anus, that triangle point. Right in my alien sphincter. Okay. Do aliens have sphincters? No, no, no. Weird. Alright, and let's go back down to the triangle. Relatively easy stuff, you know. Just making sure you get the puzzle elements down. I'm sure the game's going to pick up soon. Maybe. I'm not positive on that. I would assume so, though. No item bonus, though. Boo. Alright. So. Oh, shit. Forgot about you. Oh, man. I wanted you to end the video. Alright. Well, whatever. We'll do this guy. Ah, shit. This reminds me of a particular boss from Sonic. I really can't place which one. But basically, when we step on one of these switches, these guys shoot plungers out. And we need that plunger to hit the little midget coming out of his nose hole there. Yeah, it's all... It's a very weird situation, but just roll with it, viewers, just roll with it. It's pretty easy. I mean, you can really lay on the damage very quickly. I almost got like four hits off in that one round. It's also very easy to dodge. I love that when you get hit when you're fighting a boss, it doesn't take away your equipment. That's a very nice touch. That would be particularly frustrating. All right, what are we going to have now? We beat the boss. Yeah, all right. How many is that? Three more? Are you kidding me? Man, we must be getting close to the end, viewers. I don't know. All right, excellent. World guards, three more. Good deal. Meanwhile. Okay, it looks like the whale maybe pushed our ship to some sort of castle town or something. I don't know. I wanted to do this level before the boss, but looks like we're going to do it at the end of the video. It's going to be a little bit weird format for you guys. I apologize. This is another Badger Mill level. Now, quickly, direct your attention right underneath me. There's a bag of flour. When it goes through the flames, it turns into, like, I don't know, a loaf of bread or something like that. Is that what that's supposed to be? So, remember, when an item goes through the fire, it changes shape. Well, let's see. What kind of item are we going to need here? Looks like we need some sort of, like, toothpick situation and a gun. We need a gun? Alright, well, I guess we could do that. Check this out. When you throw the treasure chest down here, it turns into, like, metal scraps. It's pretty cool. Alright, we'll see you later, metal scraps. And head over here. Oh, shit, yeah. That's, like, the item we need right there, isn't it? Just bounce on it and send it flying. Alrighty. It looked like a torch then. Okay. We got little... Oh, what is that? A mimic? Ugh. No, that's like an evil loaf of bread. We're gonna throw flour at all these things. These wheat jumping around and... Oh shit, I'm all out. I'm spent. Luckily, we can still attack with the bag. Alright, what do we have going on over here? There's a 10-pound weight. There's a key. I can't reach the key. Looks like I need to hit that weight, cause the key to launch. Now, in order to hit the weight, we need to cut that rope and... You know, earlier I was saying we needed this torch item. Oh, yeah, did you put two and two together yet? Maybe. If we send this fucker through the fire, something delightful will happen. Let's go ahead and see. Hey, yeah. Now we got a flaming torch. That will no doubt allow us to, you know, burn the rope down. Why not? So, let's burn the rope, viewers. Ha! Throw it up in there. The weight falls, the key flies. Why did I need that gun? I don't know. Maybe they thought I would need it to kill all the innocent creatures down here. Well, whatever. We got our key, so let's go ahead and just get the hell out of here. That's pretty much it. Oh man, I kind of want to send the key through the fire. I've never done that before. Oh well, no. That would be a huge waste. Okay. So, hey, let's see what these metal scraps are worth. I don't know what they are. I know the bread is worth like 900 points. It's pretty nice. Can I get a key on here too? Oh no, I knocked it over. All right, quickly. All right, last try. Here we go. Fuck yourself. Go fuck yourself. All right, we're just going to grab the metal scraps and the bread then and head on through to the other side. What do we get? Oh, 1,000 points. That's not too bad. I guess. And when you complete this level, it'll actually allow us to wrap down, as you see. Now we're back into the previous secret area. It's a big loopy-loop. Alrighty, cool. So now that we've done that, we've completed all the secret levels for now, I think. Did I miss any down here? We went up to the lighthouse. Oh yeah, I haven't done Angel Tear Falls yet. Maybe we should look into that. I don't know. And is there any other down here? Nope, not at all. Okay, so we could either go through Angel Tear Falls, or we could head up into the new area next video. You're just going to have to wait and find out. The new area being Dark Blade Forest. Ooh. Sounds pretty ominous, viewers. I don't like the giant skull on the east side of the map. But anyways, as always, thank you guys so much for tuning in, and join me tomorrow.